Back to you now on your Wednesday morning. A writer and reporter for the sports website Deadspin is coming under major fire for accusing a little boy and his family of racism. It wasn't anything that the boy said, anything that this child wrote online, but rather what he wore to a Kansas City Chiefs game over the weekend. We'll show you a picture here. Of course, his face is blurred out, but it was a full Native American headdress, and to go along with it, half of his face was painted black, half of his face was painted red, of course, for the Kansas City Chiefs colors, the team colors. Dre Clark joins us live with more on this controversy and what people on all sides are saying about it. Dre, good morning.
Yeah, Markie, hello. A big plot twist this morning. You know, some people have accused that young a boy of being racist against Native Americans and African Americans, but overnight, the boy's mother posted on Facebook that her son is actually Native American, and so is his grandfather. And she says all of this talk about her young son being a racist needs to stop right away. Meanwhile, this picture was taken Sunday at the Chiefs and Raiders game in Las Vegas. You can see that young Chiefs fan is wearing black and red face paint and also a Native American headdress. The boy was shown on national TV, and he was also videoed doing a tomahawk chop. Some of the Kansas City Chiefs players were also on the field doing the same thing, along with thousands of other people inside the arena. But after the image aired on national TV of that young boy wearing this black and red makeup here, Karan Phillips, a senior writer with Deadspin, wrote in an online article, in part, "It takes a lot to disrespect two groups of people at once." But on Sunday afternoon in Las Vegas, a Kansas City Chiefs fan found a way to hate black people and the Native Americans at the same time, saying that despite their age, who taught that this person that what they were wearing is actually appropriate? Phillips also calling out the NFL, saying that while it isn't the league's responsibility to stop racism and hate from being taught in the home, they are a league that has relentlessly participated in prejudice here. Now, certainly the NFL has changed the name of the what was the former Washington Redskins to the Washington Commanders, that happening in 2022. And Phillips has been criticized for blaming the boy for being racist. One criticism is that when Phillips posted a picture of the kid online, he only showed the black side of the boy's face and not the red side, which some say he did on purpose to provoke a strong public response. Among those calling him out on this is one person who wrote, "You really want to ruin this kid's life over him wearing his favorite team's colors? This is an embarrassing take, and you should be ashamed of yourselves." Now, Karan Phillips is sticking by his criticism of this young boy and his parents for allowing him to dress like this and go to the game. And there are some who say that Phillips is correct in calling them out for being racially insensitive. But on the other side, there are those who say that Phillips and Deadspin should be sued for actually falsely accusing this young boy of being a racist. Now, we did reach out to Deadspin, Karan Phillips, and also the NFL, but we did not get a response. Markie?
Yeah, I know we're also trying to book this young boy's mother, this family, on the show as well. But to your point, this reporter has been unabashed in his response to the criticism and the fire that he's receiving. Dre Clark, thanks so much. We're also going to be talking about this one a bit further with our newsmaker panel a little bit later on in the show, so stay tuned for that.
Thank you for watching. Go to NewsNationNow.com to find NewsNation on your television provider. And don't forget to click the red subscribe button below to get more of NewsNation's fact-driven, unbiased coverage.